Good morning, brothers and sisters. This Mass is offered for the soul of Justiniano Ceroi, 5th death anniversary. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, today the Church celebrates the Mission Sunday, which reminds each and every one of us the very fact we are received the sacrament of baptism, we are all missionaries. We remember all those who are sent into the world far and wide to proclaim the good news. We also pray for all the mission land. We pray for you people, because you have got a great obligation to proclaim Christ through your words and through your life. Today's reading emphatically speaks to us that we are not alone, God is with us. So whatever we do, it is with the grace of God, and it will bring forth fruits abundantly. In order to celebrate this Holy Mass boldly, let us call to mind our sins and ask God's mercy and pardon, and we say, I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, his anointed, to Cyrus, whom he has taken by his right hand to subdue nations before him and strip the loins of kings, to force the gateways before him that their gates be closed no more. It is for the sake of my servant Jacob of Israel, my chosen one, that I have called you by your name, conferring a title though you do not know me. I am the Lord, unrivaled. There is no other God beside me, though you do not know me. I arm you, that man may know from rising to the setting of the sun that apart from me, all is nothing. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. Give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord glory and power. O sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Tell among the nations His glory and His wonders among all the peoples. Give the Lord glory and power. The Lord is a great and worthy of praise, to be feared above all gods. The gods of the heaven are not. It was the Lord who made the heaven. Give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord, you families of peoples. Give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord the glory of His name. Bring an offering and enter His court. Worship the Lord in His temple. O earth, tremble before Him. Proclaim to the nations, God is King. He will judge the people in fairness.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. From Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the church in Thessalonica, which is in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, wishing you grace and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We always mention you in our prayers and thank God for you all, and constantly remember before God our Father how you have shown your faith in action, worked for love, and preserved through hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. We know, brothers, that God loves you and that you have been chosen, because when we brought the good news to you, it came to you not only as words, but as power and as the Holy Spirit and as utter conviction. The word of the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia. Your word is truth, O Lord. Consecrate us in the truth. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Pharisees went away to walk out between them how to trap Jesus in what he said. And they sent their disciples to him, together with the Herodians, to say, Master, we know that you are an honest man and teach the way of God in an honest way, and that you are not afraid of anyone because a man's rank means nothing to you. Tell us your opinion then. Is it permissible to pay tax to Caesar or not? But Jesus was aware of their malice and replied, You hypocrites, why do you set this trap for me? Let me see the money you pay the tax with. They handed him a denarius, and he said, Whose head is this? Whose name? Caesar's, they replied. He then said to them, Very well, give back to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God. the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, all of us wants to be happy and satisfied and fulfilled in our life. The best way to be happy and fulfilled, we should have an attitude of gratitude. We are very much indebted to everyone. Have that awareness that we have received many things in our life, we should be grateful to others. In today's first reading, Prophet Isaiah speaks about it. He tried to remind the Israelites, even though they were taken in captivity in Babylon, God in a mysterious way worked. He has taken a Persian king, Cyrus, gave him power and authority and a good heart in order to help and support the people, those who are in captivity. He sent them back to Israelites. Not only he sent them back, he even gave support to rebuild the temple. In a mysterious way, God always enters into the life of the people. Have that awareness and try to be very grateful what all the things God has done through various ways, various means, through various people. And if you are conscious and if you are aware of it, you will be always be satisfied and fulfilled. That doesn't mean that there is no suffering, there is no pain. Pain and sufferings may be there in our life, but the moment when you are conscious that God's hand is there in my life, in every situation, you will be much more strong, much more happy and joyful to go ahead with your life. We have the second reading where St. Paul speaks to the Thessalonians that he says to them that you people are really great. I came to you with the word of God, with Timothy and Silvanus. Of course, you listened my word of God, but the moment you began to listen to the word of God, you began to respond in love, in action. And he's so grateful to express the gratitude to the people, how you accepted the word of God and how you practice the word of God. And the Holy Spirit works in a silent way in your life, and you began to respond to the word of God. God always works in our life in a mysterious way. For that you need a very clear heart, a good heart. We have the gospel passage from today, St. Matthew, which is about the Pharisees who had always a malicious heart. Today's gospel we find they want to trap Jesus. For that they have got hold of Herodians. As you know, the Herodians and Pharisees, they never go together, because Pharisees were always not in term with the Roman authority, but the Herodians are always supporting. But in this situation, they began to even caught hold of Herodians and asked, go and ask the teacher that whether it is true we have to give tax to Caesar or not. There is a malice, there is a trap, and Jesus recognized. And he said to them, why you come with this malicious heart? There is a trap behind the question you asked. you first recognized that I have a goodness in me, upright man. You always speak the truth. All these things, they attributed to Jesus, but they were not able to listen to him. They were not able to follow him. Rather, they want to catch hold of him, so set a trap. That is the time Jesus asked for a coin and said, "Whose image is this?" And they said, "It is a Caesar's." Jesus gave the answer, "What belongs to Caesar, give to Caesar. What belongs to God, give to God." Of course, we have got a great obligation to civil authorities. All the facilities, all the conveniences, all the things that we receive from the civil authorities. And we have to carry the burden, and we have got the responsibility to support. That doesn't mean that we don't belong to the God. We also belong to God. The book of Genesis speaks about it. God made man in his own image, in his own likeness. So there is an image of God in us. So that means my body and my soul belongs to God. So it's not only obligation to the civil authorities or to Caesar, we also belong to God. We have to give completely to God. And sometimes this priority and this awareness is lost. So today's reading reminds us we too belong to God. So what belongs to God should be given to God. Here comes our missionary responsibility. As you know that Jesus has come as the first missionary with a mission from the Father. And he spoke to the people. He lived out what is God's will, the Father's will. And we too have received the baptism. The moment we have received the baptism, we are all missionaries. We are sent out. You may be at home, but you are a missionary, the little place where you are, the place where you walk. You may not be able to proclaim the word of God from the pulpit, but your word, your action, your testimony for Christ is always bearing witness to Christ. You are called for it, conscious about it. There are also people specially chosen and sent out, and they have dedicated their life. So remember those missionaries specially sent out. And also the mission land. All the land belongs to God. And take care of it. Everything belongs to God. So we have got a great obligation. So my brothers and sisters, as we celebrate the Mission Sunday, let us also be conscious, not only our testimony, but which all the ways we can support the mission, we should. Even your contribution, a little sacrifice that you make from your own earnings for the mission of Christ, where you are in need of the word of God as well as in action, it has to be proclaimed. Whatever we get out of it, it has to reach to the Holy Father in order to reach out to the people far and wide, because everyone belongs to God and everyone is a brother and sister of ours. May God give us the grace so that we may always be conscious about our responsibility and we may be true missionaries. May God bless each and every one of us. Amen. Please arise and let us proclaim our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried, he descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us bring our needs of our world before God, to whom all things belong. And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That each member of the church may spread the good news of God's love, not only by words, but by a life of conviction, empowered by the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the laws and policies of all nations may always defend and promote the dignity of the human person created in God's image. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those seeking a cure for the pandemic, those responsible for public safety, and all those who provide necessary services in this time may be guided and protected by God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may gladly place at God's disposal all that we have received from His goodness, and never disfigure His image in us by selfishness, sin, or disobedience. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may rejoice to see the face of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. In silence of our heart, we pray for our personal intentions. God our Father, receive the praise and thanks of your church. Grant that we may fulfill the mission which you have entrusted to us by showing our faith in action, walking of love, and persevering in hope through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, your sacrifice and my sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord bless up the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, and through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity and even fashioned for us remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with this in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim: Holy, 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 God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with the Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
May the receiving of the body of the Lord Jesus Christ not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for me protection in mind and body. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Communion antiphon. The Son of Man has come to give his life as a ransom for many. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord. Pray for those who are affected by the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found. We pray for the government and health authorities that the efforts to curb this pandemic may bear good results. We pray for all the people, especially our parish people, they may remain strong, committed in their faith and belief. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. The parish announcements. This weekend, we are celebrating Mission Sunday. Let us be generous towards the mission worldwide. Confirmation for children of our parish will be held on Thursday, 29th October, during 7 p.m. Mass. Only for that day, the siblings below 8 years of the confirmation candidates are allowed to attend the Holy Mass. Holy Communion will be held on 4th and 5th November during 7 p.m. Holy Mass. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Celebration is over. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good day.